Hello everyone, and let's check out another beautiful chess game by Garry Kasparov. And in this chess game, Garry Kasparov has the white pieces, and his opponent is Ronaldo Abud. And this game was played in the Sao Paulo Chess Simul. And this was an exhibition chess game. And let's check out how this game went on. Garry Kasparov starts the game with playing e4, e5. Knight to f3 and d6 by Abud. And this is the Philidor's defense. Maybe this would be a good opening in the early 19th century or even in the 18th century. But against Garry Kasparov in 2004, Philidor's defense is busted. Especially if you play the Philidor's defense against a chess master. For example, against a grandmaster. Like Garry Kasparov, a super grandmaster, you probably would lose the game by force. So Philidor's defense against Kasparov was a bad idea. We have d6 by Abud, and today, in the highest level chess tournaments, you are never going to see the Philidor's defense for the records. So let's continue. After d6, we have d4, knight to c6, bishop to b5, a6. And this is already losing for black. Why? Well, Garry Kasparov captured the knight, capturing pack, and d takes on e5. And white is much better, as you can see. We have bishop to g4, not capturing the pawn. If capturing back, then queen takes on d8, king takes on d8, and knight takes on e5. And as you can see, the pawns are weak. But most importantly, and also white is a pawn up, and this is losing for black. Let's get back to the real game. So after bishop to g4, we have e takes on d6 by Kasparov. And Garry Kasparov is a pawn up. Knight to c3, bishop to e7, h3, bishop to h5, bishop to f4, knight to f6. And Kasparov played queen to d2, and then his opponent castled, also Kasparov castled from the opposite direction. He castled in the queen side, knight to e8, and Kasparov is attacking from the king side and immediately advancing with the pawns, bishop to g6, knight to d4, queen to c7, h4 by Kasparov, threatening h5, h6, h5 again, attacking the bishop. Bishop to h7, and in this position, Kasparov played the best move, and he pushed the pawn, g5, a very strong pawn advancement from the king side. H takes on g5, and bishop takes on g5, knight to f6, queen to f4, rook from a to d8, and Kasparov is lining the rook with the king, running away, king to h8. And h6 by Kasparov, the best move. And black is in trouble. As you can see, Garry Kasparov is viciously advancing with his pawns in the king side. And black is helpless in this position. We have knight to e8 by black. If capturing the pawn or pushing the pawn, then bishop takes on f6. And this is losing for black. And we have knight to e8, preparing to face h takes on g7 with the knight. Kasparov captured the pawn, knight takes on g7. But Garry Kasparov played a bone-crushing move. It is white to move. What would you do in this position? And in this position, Garry Kasparov played a killer move. What would you do in this position? If capturing the bishop, there is nothing special for white. But again, white is still winning, but not as crushing as the move which was played in the game by Kasparov. Well, Garry Kasparov played rook takes on h7 by Kasparov, sacrificing the exchange. What a move. A vicious, wild move by Kasparov. King takes on h7, and then queen to h4, that's check. And black resigned. Because black is getting checkmated by force. There is no defense. Let me show you the possible continuation. King to g8 and bishop to f6. Threatening checkmate. Rook takes knight. The knight is pinned. Bishop takes on f6 and queen takes on f6. And there is no defense. Let's say d5. And queen takes on g7. Checkmate. So this is why Garry Kasparov, without blinking his eye, sacrificed the exchange. Rook takes on h7. Check. And this is losing. If king to g6, then queen to h6. Checkmate. Once again. So this is why, after queen to h4 by Kasparov, black resigned. Today we don't see Philidor's defense anymore in the highest level chess tournaments. And probably playing the Philidor's defense against Kasparov was a very bad idea. And thank you for watching. And I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye bye.